toward changing the face of 21st century teaching, one video lesson at a time.
This is good. You know, there could be, which is rare, but it could be the case that someone is watching. Maybe watching a video, and there are questions there, and you simply don't care. You just pick the answer just to make sure the video keeps going. Then you pick another answer for the score. It depends how lucky you are. You may get 100, but you didn't really think about it. You just guessed. And you may get also low, and the teacher will spend their time finding out what's wrong, why did they have the content, what you actually didn't even care to study it. There could be, you know, those instances.
Well, I would say that there will be some, but not all. A vast majority, as you said before, are here to learn.
And yes, it's what they also said yesterday. We're not supposed to make decisions based on 5% of the class or the group. So it's true. Just to be aware that it could be the case with some. So maybe we can find out, if we see a very low score, what was the reason? Did you actually really study?
Yeah.
I mean, we can even bluntly ask, did you really study?
Yeah. And another thing about that making a decision based on the 5%, we should also not punish 100% based on the 5%. So be careful when trying to teach a lesson to just a small number of people that you actually, because students are, for the lack of a really nice word to say, like a pack of wolves. You attack one, actually the whole thing, the whole gang will actually attack you. So be careful when engaging students in a defensive manner. So remember, there's the 95% who are doing it honestly. Okay, so how do you create an account with that? You can actually watch this and then start doing the registration. So
okay, so what you do is you log out and you sign in as Thank you.
So this is student.
Student.
So log out. Let's say hello. First thing, community will show videos that you can use, and you can see that the video here, because it's a community video, it's already have questions embedded. So you can look at, so that one has 11, that one has 10, that one has 17 questions already there.
Okay. Oh, those are questions, I thought they were likes.
So the raindrop shape, isn't it? So that is the amount of questions. So for, let's say, exploring the atmosphere, there's already 10 questions embedded. So if you want to see where the questions are, just click on that. Okay. And then you can, so these are all the questions. Already there. And this video here already have 38 other versions. That was done by other teachers with different
questions,
different questions, right. Different amount of questions.
So what they did, they used that video, they removed the questions from there, and
yes.
Put their own.
So you don't have to remove anything; you just edit your own thing. Because what
that puzzle does is actually it takes the video from YouTube. Okay? But it does not infringe on any copyright, because what it does is actually it sort of layer the questions on top of the YouTube video. So that is no issue of copyright infringement.
So all the videos we see here in this camera section, many of them are taken from YouTube,
yes,
made by some other creators.
Yes.
Not necessarily for the one who has,
yes,
the camera and record.
You don't have.
You can, but
you
don't have to.
That's what we saw in the video, but you don't have.
Because at first glance, when I saw this, I thought, wow, this teacher is so advanced to create this video. But he just saw it, she took it from YouTube.
From YouTube. Okay. So, from YouTube, there are many sources or many channels in YouTube that they take videos from. These are quite important, quite popular ones, like Khan Academy. So anybody who's in the sciences field, mathematics, know something about Khan Academy. Click on Khan Academy. So these are Khan Academy videos. Okay. So it talks about normally maths, physics. So that's very interesting for that. You can also have from the National Geographic channel in YouTube. So again, you can have TED Talks, Veritasium, Namapile. So to search for a video that you want to use for your class, you can also click here and start typing. So let's find any video related to what you are teaching. Because these are community, that means you already have these videos from this community.
Yes. You can go from YouTube, you can go on.
But I can see a video with no questions at all.
It's different.
Video with no questions at all, that means those videos have not been created.
So, what was the point of putting here by this person? Oh, just to keep them there. They probably just assign this video to the students, but no questions.
Okay.
So just
we can use that the question is to we can use this.
You can use
cat.
You can use it as it is.
You want to edit it, so we edit.
Find a video. I'm just curious, in the YouTube section, when you look, for example, at Kilian discourse analysis, YouTube shows all the videos, is it just the videos from YouTube that some other creators were here?
Yes.
Or it's all videos on YouTube?
All videos on YouTube.
So it's basically the same as I do search on YouTube?
Yes.
Whereas the search here is the same?
Yes, exactly.
Maybe that's why there are no questions, because no one used it.
Yes. You can even use the YouTube link and paste it to
that.
It goes to YouTube. So you can right away assign a video. So let's say this is a video that was curated by Jennifer here, and we already have the questions here. And you can review the question by clicking on this. Okay, so you can click, so preview, so what happened, so you will be able to see the questions. If you like the question, then you can assign it right away by clicking this. Okay? But let's say for example you want to create your own questions. Okay? So you click on edit. Yeah? So click on edit on your video. Okay? So now you have the power to cut voiceover or questions. Okay, so cutting means short, making the video shorter. But you can also have sections of videos. So that means if you have, so this is only a 2 minute video. So let's say you have a video lecture which is 10 minutes, 15 minutes long. Then you want to have the first 5 minutes and then the last 2 minutes. You can actually do that by going into, so if you go to cut here, just click on anywhere in the video.
So yeah, superstructure,
so
can pull under.
Okay, so you click on add cut. So what happens when you click on that one, it will give you 2 segments.
So that you can adjust.
So you are not limited to having use the same, the whole video, that's number one, the full video, and you are not limited to having to go through the sections that you don't need. You can actually have a cut like this, and then the video will automatically jump to the next section. So that's really useful, isn't it?
Then you can have voice over also?
The voice over, I'm not sure whether. Now it's blocked. But the question is where you put in a question. Okay? You can use the question that this person have created, but you can, let's say for example you want to edit the text, you can edit the text, or you want to delete, just click on delete. So it will not affect the it will not affect that the person's work. It will only affect on your copy. Okay, so you don't have to worry about deleting other people's work inside that button. Okay, so and then you can start adding multiple choice questions or other types of questions. So to ask multiple choice questions, so it's quite straightforward, isn't it? So try and ask one multiple choice question in your video.
This one.
You want to end here?
So you pause that.
about that and then it will be.
Okay,
the question will be embedded where you pause the video. Always add choices by clicking this. Mm. So normally multiple choice will have four options, isn't it? You can embed multiple questions in a place. Okay. So for example here, this is one question. If I want to add another question, I can always just click at the bottom here. So add questions.
So it can have multiple questions.
Yes, you can have multiple questions in one time step.
Only add another answer.
So after you've completed the question,
you've
already
continue.
So you can add more questions. So how do you add, how do you design a true false question using multiple choice?
Just to ask.
So this actually has potential of not just multiple choice, but also true false questions.
Okay. Did you say that?
So now you will see two questions in the same time step. So this time step has two questions. One of it is actually the true false question. So this is the second question that we designed. So after you've added your question, so don't add too many questions. You can do that later when we when you want to go with your students.
So required students with questions.
Then yes, that's finish, right?
So when you're done, you click on finish.
Okay. But can we delete later when we create it?
Yeah, you can. So after you're done, when you're done, finish, you will be shown this. Okay. Yeah. Now you can assign it to your students. Okay. So the way to assign it is by clicking on this. Assign this video to the class.
Alright. Not class yet.
Okay. So if you don't have class yet, then you need to add. I have a lot of classes, so it shows like this. Classroom with the students. Okay, that means
it's a contact session with the students. So you click online mode, everybody signs in, and then you move the so this is the instruction. So share screen with the students, and then get to the class. Live mode assignment will automatically appear, and then the students will do the responses, and you can actually track it live.
What's the difference, live mode, or you share and you just tell them, okay, all of you, if you change your mind and want to do it in class, you just tell them, okay, all of you get to this video now.
This actually updates the results live in front of you. So yeah, so it will show where the students are at during the video, mm-hmm. and also the status of their question, their answers, if it's correct or wrong. Mm-hmm. So that's why.
But then the video cannot move on when it's stopped, when it's paused for a question. It cannot move on until all 20 students respond.
No. It will move with each student.
Because they
are using their own devices.
Okay, they're still using their own device.
Yeah.
Okay, it's just.
So another one is the homework type. So that means the students are given the link and they go through it in their own time. What we will get is actually a screenshot of the result that where the students are at. Okay, so let me show you an example. So this is what you will see as an educator zone in the shared assignment. So I can see that all the students have already watched the video except for this one person. That's it. And the question, everybody got the right answer. So let me try and find the one with. Okay, so let's look at this one. Okay, so you can see that the students are at different stages of the video here. Okay, and there are, because there's only one question, so they will get the one attempt. But some turn in. Some others will turn. So those are how the educators will be able to see. So let's say, for example, this one. So from here, you will be able to see where the students' achievement are at each question to give you the indication of what to teach in the classroom. Isn't it?
Right.
So this video have 1, 2, 3, 4 questions. So you can actually go in, and so this is all the open-ended question. So you don't really get to see right away the right or wrong one, because those are auto mark. I normally don't. I very rarely use sort of auto marking questions in my interaction with students, because I wanted them to discuss their answers in the classroom.
Oh.
So let me try and find the ones with.
When you assign those open-ended questions in the class, do you encourage having a discussion where they provide these answers, or maybe you saw some really interesting answers and you just go straight to the student and ask him what you're going
yes.
to share.
Yeah, exactly. So, I want to encourage interaction in the class. So I normally find things that we can discuss.
So basically, this open-ended question, they sort of do this activity twice, first at home,
yeah.
and then in class, again, we might have the same discussion where you can express again the same view.
Yeah. So,
let's see.
Go in and see apologies for that. Let's
see what we all have. Don't worry.
So let's see this one. Okay, so then you'll be able to then single out students. So this student may have problems, and then you can actually assign them further work or give them further understanding from what they didn't understand well. Maybe you can ask them during the session. But if you can see that all the students got the answer right, then you are able then to move on. Or you then sort of leave the learning outcome for that, because so from your assessment, you see that so these students have already got that learning outcome. So then you move on to the next learning outcome for the class. So that's how you use Edpuzzle, the videos, and also the questions in the video to help you design your contact session with the students.
How do you embed this video?
Okay, so that's the next part, right? So the question is, how do we embed the video or the video into Spectrum? So what you do is when you go into your question here, you can actually share assignment. Okay, so there are two ways for you to embed those video into your Spectrum. So if you go to Spectrum here, for example, so first start with turning editing on. Okay, and then let's normal way that we use Spectrum is add activity. So you can either use URL which correspond to the link, okay, or you can embed the code which I did just now, or what the one that you see in our Spectrum by using a page. Okay, so if we go to Spectrum, there is this page where you can embed it in the page. Okay, so let's try an embedding in the page, because embedding using URL is very easy, isn't it? But let's try it with a page. So you click on add a page. Okay, it will take you to this part. So let's try and do that with your Spectrum.
Do you have access to Spectrum?
I have access, but not editing.
Oh, not editing.
Yes.
So if it's not editing, then it would not be possible for you.
Sure.
So you just watch. Yeah. Sure. How we. So, are you in your Spectrum now?
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So, when we are here, of course, you need to have a name for it. So, just put in the name here. For example, so what to write in the description?
We have to add the link.
That's later. So what I want to see whether you are paying attention.
Just instructions.
Right.
Instructions.
Okay.
What
yes.
Video and answer question.
Okay. So what else? The good practice.
Oh, time.
Yes.
7 minutes.
Okay. So. What?
7 minutes.
Register as student. Register as student. Watch. And answer questions. Okay. So let's see. Let's say 4 minutes. So now we get to sort of embed that into our Spectrum, and we use the content part. So you have two parts here, the description part and also the content part.
Maybe we need to click display description for page.
Yes, of course. Okay. So you want to add that into the page content, so click on the advanced button. Because we are embedding HTML code. Okay. So now go to your Add Puzzle. You can change this from small to medium to large. So bigger is better. Copy code. Okay. Go back to your editing page and then click on the HTML. And then, so you click on Control V, so to paste.
Control V?
Yeah.
Yes. You paste this one, right?
Okay. Alright, so click the HTML button again. Save and return to course. So you already created this
for the students to see. So when the students click on that, they will be able to see this. So try and go up.
The video will be seen, they will be able to see the video when they are inside.
Oh, they cannot see.
Ah, but you don't put it on the page.
Is it possible? So it's reflected on the page?
You can show it on the page. Just use the display part, then you will see.
Mm-hmm. Which part?
That's how you embed Edpuzzle video. So apart from Edpuzzle, there is a built-in video interactive video function within Moodle you can use, within Spectrum that you can use, which is H5P. Okay. So if I click on an activity, and I click on the black interactive content here. So let's try with your Spectrum as well. So click on this one. So here you have a possibility of 47 types of content that you can do. A lot of things that you can do. And what we are looking for is this one, interactive video. Have the same function as Edpuzzle, but it has its own drawback, which is you don't have the ability to cut video. So if you want to be able to cut video, use Edpuzzle rather than H5P. Okay. Any of you tried this H5P before? No. Okay. So that's activity that's interactive with the students can be used to design your flipped classroom content. Okay, so you have interactive video, course presentation, and the advantage of interactive video is similar to Edpuzzle, course presentation is similar to PowerPoint, but you can embed questions.
But you basically start creating it right there.
Yeah, you are creating the presentation in here. And you can add presentation add assessment within the cross presentation. So similar to your PowerPoint, but then after a few slides, there's question for them to answer. After a few slides, you can put in questions for them to answer. Okay. And then you have quite a number of the normal ones that we use. Like multiple choice, quiz, fill in the blanks, but it has quite a number of advanced
but the functionalities. But if you choose interactive video, then we have to upload the video in there, right?
No, it will give you the option to paste YouTube link.
Oh, okay.
H5P. So, in interactive video. So, let's try and do the same thing with interactive video. So click on interactive video.
Yes,
No, it's not that one. The black one.
Oh, okay.
Black one, black. Question.
is? Typing this in Malay, so just for example. Okay, so that's my first question. So this is my second question. Once they start the video, they will immediately be hit with this thing. So you just click and so single choice set means you need to choose from one. So when the students click, for example, they click this one. It's wrong. Okay. So it will show you the right one. And then you move on to the next question.
But this was the option display time.
Yes.
So it means that in a separate window we need to go through the video, see where we want to pause, and then go back to Spectrum and specify the display time.
Yes.
Because it doesn't show you what we write display time, there's no video at the same time, so we can check what exactly we hear what we need to specify. We don't have a video.
Oh, okay, so what you need before you go into this. So you can actually still move this here, the cursor. So you pause to where you want the interactive thing to happen.
Okay. And only then. Okay, so I want this to happen. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And then I ask.
Yeah.
And that's all.
So now you can pause. So it already showed you the display time.
Okay. So it's not a question. And then once done?
Done. Yeah. Right. You have not put in the
question. But when I click down, it goes back, it takes me back to the video.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
Okay. So let's try embedding a single choice set. So it can be like a normal question like this, or it's a statement. So you can have longer answers here. Or single choice set.
But it's a choice. Why is it single choice? It's a multiple choice.
So from a choice, from choices, just pick one. So before it moves on. So when you click on the right answer, it will move on. Just that they name it single choice set.
the first answer is always the correct.
Oh, okay.
First
answer. Oh.
Someone should read before it's empty. Okay. Add the range, score range.
And we can add the answer, right?
Yes, we can add the answer.
But what is score range?
Score range?
Oh, like if it's correct 100%?
Score range.
Yeah.
Okay, so score range, you can give personalized feedback for different score ranges. Okay, so for example here, you have 0 to 100. So you click on add range. So now you can have 0 to 50 and then 50, 51 to 100. Okay. So when the students get 0 to 50, maybe you want to say poor choice, try it. Okay. So 50 to 100, so good try. Well done.
Oh.
Isn't it? So you can actually have that different feedback for different scoring. So if, what do you say to A students, what do you say to B students, what do you say to C students, what do you say to K students? Okay, so that's what scoring is. Yes, but you don't have to do this. Yeah, but you can put in feedback. Because normally what I always suggest to educators, when you do interactive activities, the students don't get instant gratification from the lecturer saying, okay, so you got it right, isn't it? So feedback is where you put in that reinforcement of, okay, you've done well, isn't it? So it's personalized in a way that you did it yourself. And then if they didn't do well, so they got the wrong answer, you don't want them to see, well, then you got it right, isn't it? So maybe you want to say, try again, or maybe you want to give feedback so that then they can search for the answer. So that means, for example, for the C or for the D students, then you write, you may find the answer by looking at things before, isn't it? So which chapter, or so tell them where they can find the answer. So that's where the feedback comes in for the students. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so I would suggest that you explore the different types of interactive internet that you can do. So here you do the single choice set, so maybe in the next part where you want to ask questions, you ask something else. You can move this by clicking on that. Position the title anywhere you like. So sometimes it covers that important slide or the important part of the video, isn't it? Okay, So that's Edpuzzle and also H5P. So let's look at the next part in our of a non-video resource that you use. And again, if you see here, part 3 has 3.1. So 3.1 is the assessment from what the learner have read in this blog post. So you click on this one, it will take you to Flipped Classroom blog post that we've written. Okay, and then the learners are supposed to do that one. Okay, so that means they go into the assessment, and this assessment is based on what they have read here. So, the ones who have already did the assessment, what is your feedback on the article that was written? Do you remember reading it? this is the the response, the score.
This one from the...
So, this will tell me that... question number one.
E.
Oh, that's E, yeah.
Yes. Or remember, I got it too wrong.
Okay. So, it shows that a lot of students didn't get it right here. A lot of students got this right. So, yeah, so we have 6 questions. So, students got it right mostly on question number 2. So you use this information. So let's say, for example, that is where you put your learning outcomes. Okay. So that means I need to work on learning outcome number 1 because a lot of students didn't get it. Okay. Mm-hmm. What was the question? The first question.
How many paragraphs?
How was it?
How many paragraphs in the article?
Okay. Yeah, so I need to work on that.
Work on paying attention. How many paragraphs are in the article? I guess it's more about... but for some people, I think it's natural just to pay attention to these details, while others are just focusing on the content.
Yeah, exactly.
But so many people answered, and only 3 of us came today. So we need
to... these are
manage the classroom.
Yes.
Yeah.
But still,
how councils.
I mean, you are going to be a curator, just like you were before, selecting resources. So unless you are not confident in how, what are the best ways maybe to deliver pre-taught material, unless this, you can work into this. It gives you a general overview, but it's already enough to know of the approach or the different approach.
From what we sort of what we thought when writing this, it's we are trying to give enough example so that those who think they are bold enough or brave enough to start trying it can start trying doing it. Of course, an article cannot train you or prepare you for a proper flip session. You still need to sort of go into training, even though so you read the article, you tried it once, okay, so now how do I sort of progress for the reason? So the article is in between that, I would say. When we wrote it the way that we wrote it, hopefully. That was the intention in it. Okay? But I think it will have enough sort of guidance for a session, because it talks about, so if you go into, where was it? Here, so how does it work? So we try to bring the learner or the reader to imagine a class, isn't it? So as an educator, so when you imagine the class, then we know roughly how it went. So that's why we have the before, okay, during, and then after. Where was the after? Or we didn't put in after. Oh yeah, we didn't have the after. Probably we can improve this by having it after. We have before and during. Okay, so flip resources, you can see that it's possible to use not just video but articles as well. And you put in a question. Of course, the questions are sort of not maybe academic type question, how many paragraphs are there.
Just an example
to see how it can work. You can always ask a more advanced question, or you can reserve the advanced question during the class. Mm-hmm. So get them to read first, get them measure whether they have read the article by asking simple questions based on the article, but you will reserve the more advanced, the more application type of questions during the class. So you know already that from the results, the students are reading the articles. Okay, so we are at 12 o'clock. So what I want you to do now is I want you to start creating or curating a lesson, plan a lesson in the flip model based on whatever that you are teaching. So plan just now. Before, during, and after. So you can use this as a guide to describe what you are doing. Okay, but I want you to put it in context. I want you to create a flip based on a single topic. Is that okay? All right. You can do it in spectrum. You can write like a descriptive description, but it needs to be in context. I mean, the article or the video that you're going to use is you mentioned it. Okay. So I'm giving you 30 minutes.
Okay, to plan one single lesson from start to finish.
Wow, that's a big time constraint.
And to
help my students, I think 30 minutes.
Is this the amount of time, Dr. Zahir, you need to prepare for your class?
Huh?
30 minutes is the time you need to prepare for your class?
Sometimes.
If this is so, then you need to give us another lecture on how to do that.
Okay, to make it more interesting, so I'm going to display the timer.
Yeah, that's very interesting.
I like to use timer like this in my classroom. It focus.
What's this? It's just Google?
It's just Google. Yeah, it's Google online timer.
Oh, okay.
So you Google online timer.
Oh, online timer.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that comes up.
That's you. Before we're giving you some websites with all sorts of ads. But it's good.
Yeah, just simple. Once we. Okay, so you can do it anywhere. You can do it in your Spectrum. You can do it in your blog. You can do it in Edpuzzle if you want. But I want to know the before, the during, and then also the after. And then in the next 30 minutes, we are going to hear the presentation.
Okay.
Because I've spoken since 9 o'clock, so now it's your turn.
Okay, you can go and have some food over there. Still a lot.
Thank you. We have 12 minutes and 30 seconds. Alright, 26 seconds. Instructions. So what's the jury? So think about what's going to happen during the context session.
Question name and question text. What's that mean?
Okay, question name is for you. So that, let's say, for example, you want to ask, what is this course? Definition of this course. Question text is what you tell the students, what you ask. The question name will not be visible to the students.
Okay.
Question text.
Thank you.
So normally you will add the quiz, but then you would sort of extend it to the, yeah, you push it to the right.
Push it to the right, then it will be still under the same teacher.
It will, so it's actually not that, okay. But it will give the impression that it is.
Okay. And then supposed to know the basic principle. Then the second, the third part is about the video also. Again, you ask them to how the separation. So I will give the scenario like A and B, how they separate. Alright? So that is a question during the, they watch the video. And I end this recap with the part of photography. Again, they learn during the analytic chemistry one. So they know about that there is a two main type of chromatography. So they read the article, maybe they need maybe 5 minutes to understand it, because this is just a recall, right? So it should be fast. And then at the end, they will do a reading assessment based on the articles, maybe they just 3 minutes. So once they complete this task, should be in my class, I can cut the 15 minutes, go to the advanced, I can give a one at a simple version, ask them to solve the problem as well.
So, so everything that you created here will be used in the class for is it application or is it refreshment?
This one is a refreshment. Okay. So once they come to my class, the idea is I will give like a one class about, let's say that again this is still basic, but I want to test them how they understand that all the terms. So maybe I can give them see how, I think I have to see the progress from here, then only I can know that what type of question they can ask. Right?
Okay. So then I give them an example, an office desk, and
they have to think about what is the materials being used in there. Finally, they have to watch another video about advanced manufacturing, like additive manufacturing. It's one of the latest technologies in manufacturing. Actually, here I want them to have a perspective that manufacturing, not just what we have right now from conventional methods, there is another new technologies, but why it is not replacing what we have right now. So I want to know what is their opinion. They have to write a short essay, and by the end of the course, they will have the answer for this question, not for this lesson. So this one will give them the importance of this whole course. Okay. Then during the lecture, we are going to discuss a certain problem. For example, we have RC car. This is a small toy, but have different materials, starting from electronics and these high tech, until we have plastics, metals, and these materials. So now we are going to analyze this in terms of materials, what they have. It's about discussion, so they can learn from each other. Sometimes they can come up. Later on, they have a lab session to go to the workshop and see the machines there, so they can touch them, not just watching the video. And finally, they can have an assignment to consider a product they select by themselves to reflect these 4 points that we have.
Question.
Yeah.
So when you say short essay just now, I would. So what do you have in mind?
Usually, what I mean by short essay is like half a page.
So that
is limited with number of words, like 500 words.
So you actually put that.
Yes. Sure.
The instructions.
Yeah.
And I would suggest is you don't give them the assignment.
Mm-hmm.
The assignment is part of the class.
Okay.
So I think that because they have done the learning beforehand.
Mm-hmm.
So the homework, even the report, is actually part of they can do it in a group, for example, small groups.
Yeah.
So let's say, for example, the sort of the work or the part of the class is done in large groups, let's say, for example, 4 or 5 groups. But when it comes to the short report, just have a pair doing that. So then it's more personalized to them.
Okay.
So I think we are using this opportunity for differentiated learning. So that means everybody will have their own learning.
Yes.
So use that potential by either giving the report to be written personally, one by one, or it's like a smaller group.
Small.
Yeah, smaller group. So you can use that, the one during lecture for larger group, for example,
yeah.
This, if you have, for example, 50 students, divide it into 5 groups, or 10 people. But then when you do the report at the end, not as an assignment, things still is being done in class.
Okay. Something like continuation.
Continuation. And another thing, I just remembered that for any collaborative session or interactive session, we need to leave 10 to 15 minutes at the end of the class time to round up the discussion. I see quite a number of examples where this section or this portion was missing. And because students are doing work by themselves, although you are sort of facilitating them along the way, the last 10 or 15 minutes where you basically sum up everything for everybody is very important to validate their efforts and also the knowledge that they created. Isn't it? Because otherwise, I get feedback from students. If we don't have that 10-15 minutes, they became lost because they were not confident what do they have done is the right thing. So they need that last feedback as impossible. This is like what we did. Or this is also where you so after you've gone through the overview of everything that the students do, so if you see any mistakes or any errors, the last 10 minutes or 15 minutes is where you actually emphasize. So the right thing is this.
So for the learners, they will see
You mean the line?
Yeah,
the line.
How to add the separator?
You can actually add the separator by using the label. Okay. So, for example, let's go to yours. So, what you do is you add an activity and label, okay, and just put in dash. Click on that.
first one. Time to do magic in front. Oh, yes.
First one.
If you plan to just
whiz through the whole semester with flip after flip after flip, then you will not have time to sort of regroup and strategize what works, what doesn't work. And it will also be taxing to the learners as well, because they have not done this before, and suddenly they have to sort of go into this the whole semester, isn't it? So again, there is that risk of kickback from the students, saying, "Oh, this is not what I signed up for." So you, in the beginning, of course, you start slow, okay, and then in order for you to be able to run the next semester when the students have already sort of familiarized themselves with it, and they are mentally prepared to do flipped classroom.
So one thing that I find teachers wrong, the first in the class, is they use video resources. Now, not to say that those other resources aren't, but I'm sure they are. I don't want kids to watch video. I want kids to interact with it. Learn who the efficacy of a flipped classroom is greatly built in the teacher, is the creator of the classroom. And if you can build an interaction with these, it greatly enhances the learning experience. I like to say it's like a layer on top. So what happens is you continue to take your video and as it's playing, who's the teacher, who's the reporter, you're watching, you can see it in 1 minute, pause the video, and a question will pop up, the students then respond.
This is when the time before and buzzer. So let buzzer solve this problem.
Over their shoulders, so to speak, knowing what they're doing.
I was reminded that we need to take pictures.